looking back over my years, I guess I shed some tears. Told myself time and time again, this time I'm gonna win. But another fight, things ain't right, I'm losing again. Takes a few to lose. I am going to jump straight into it. This is going to be a message to all of my divine masculines. The reason why I am taking the time to shout you guys out is because I feel that y'all don't get enough recognition. Y'all don't get enough praise. Y'all don't get enough, y'all are not met enough with the energy of understanding and the ability to sympathize, if that makes sense, especially when it comes to like a lot of our feminists, because a lot of our feminists are in the energy of trying to purge and heal different aspects of ourselves to kind of shield and mold ourselves and protect ourselves in whatever way that we can do. And a lot of times it can come off in the form of like bitterness or like bashing the men, or y'all feel this energy from the feminist collective as far as the energy of feeling like you're not enough, or that you're not supplying enough, or you're not doing enough, you are not worthy enough, especially when it comes to the area of not being financially set or financially where you want to be in life. I feel like insecurities is another big one as well. You guys are dealing with the judgment of different women's perspective and how it has made you feel over the time of growing up, and also just dealing with a lot of inner wounds, a lot of childhood wounds that you're trying to heal at this time. The way that my throat chakra just wanted to close off, you guys are having a hard time trying to speak up for yourself and just set those boundaries that's needed, and also speak your mind as far as your truth when it comes to the things that you love, the things that you are passionate about at this time. I feel like a lot of you are going through a death and rebirth. A lot of you are, earlier I heard bloodshed, so it's like some of you guys could have actually dealt with a lot of bloodshed as well. A brown bird is significant. You could be seeing brown birds. You could be seeing birds more often. I feel like you guys are about to be hit with a burst of energy that's going to bring about the shit that's needed. Interruptions and distractions is heavy here, the way that the train keeps going as I'm trying to talk. Something that can't necessarily be controlled, I guess, on my end. So it's like a need to... there's like a need to just allow things to be. Don't try to control. Just allow things to be. I want you to know that you are worthy. I want you to know that you're smart. I want you to know that you're smart. You're giving. You are kind. I love my divine masculines. I need my divine masculines. I need my men. I adore my men. I cherish y'all. I see you. I sympathize with you. I love how strong you are. I love how charismatic you are. I love how handsome you are. I'm proud of your mother for molding you to be in the best way that she could. I give gratitude to your mother and thanks to her. I give thanks to your father for helping to create you as well, whether he's here or not here. You are here. And you are seen. And you are heard. And you are felt across the nation. And us women, we do see y'all. And there's women out here who do still care. There's women out here who will listen. Who will hear you. Who won't do things to, like, we're trying, I'm going to say as women, to move into an energy of leading with unconditional love when it comes to y'all. Nine-one-one, it's an emergency. I'm proud of y'all for the shift that you guys have done recently, for having the strength to be able to overcome every obstacle that was thrown in your way. And I don't mean it like obstacle. I know you understand what I mean, the in-depths of what I'm saying. Again, I feel you. I know the things that you went through is, some of the things are unspeakable. Some of the things still cause trauma, PTSD. I feel you. I see you. I sympathize with you. Love and light.